Hello guys, so in this video we'll prepare the data set. So as the instructor said, we'll go to the Project Gutenberg. You can see the link here. If you go to this web page, you'll see there are many ebooks which you can download for free as a text version. So we are going to use these ebooks for our analysis. So for you, what we have done, we have created an archive which contains all the which contains selected papers which we are going to use for our analysis. So you need to download and unzip the archive of some papers containing 85 documents that we'll use for our analysis. These 85 documents have been extracted from this Project Gutenberg ebook version. When you unzip the archive, it will create a directory called data. So you will have a folder named data. This will be our working directory. So what you have to do, you have to, whatever Python code you are going to create, just create it in this data folder. We have the data, we'll be using NLTK library, which comes with the Anaconda Cloud. So you can just try importing NLTK in your Python console and you can see that it is working. Make sure you download all the collections of NLTK using NLTK download. So before we can proceed with the analysis, we need to load the files containing all the 85 papers into convenient data structures. Okay. The first step is to assign each of the 85 papers to the proper set. Since all the files have a standard format, we can easily assign each paper to its corresponding authors. For this, we'll use the dictionary data structure. So the idea with the dictionary data structure is it comes with the key and the value pair. So with each key, you can store its value and you can easily access this particular value using the key. So if some of you know basic data structure, then you must know hashing also. In hashing, what we do, we create a hash of a particular data, and whenever that we want to extract the data, we'll use that hash value to extract the data. So the dictionary data type contains key value pairs. In our case, the key would be the author's name and the list of paper numbers will be the values associated with these keys. So let's see the data one.